Yes, you can see one string is given here, right? And the parse table is given here. Can you parse this string like this using this method? What this method? Sorry. Why I'm doing this to show you, there is a little different between the last parsing technique and this parsing technique. We can reduce one of the one of the column. Okay, let me show you how to use this table and parse the given string. Okay, so what we have to have here to do this is the first row, sorry, first column is just an action number, so there is nothing. Next, we need to maintain a stack, we already know. We have to have a stack. Then we will have symbol. Okay, and then we will have the input. We have to have an input here, okay, and finally we have action here. Okay, so initially we know the stack will have state 0, okay, then symbol is nothing matched initially, so it will be empty. Input given here is ID multiplication ID plus ID, and we augment it with dollar. Okay, so this is the initial condition. Now we have to start with this given table, okay, and we'll try to solve it. Okay, so if you say top of the stack here is 0 and we have current input that is ID. So what we are going to do, we'll try to search for action, current state 0 and input symbol is ID. Okay, so if you see it is shift 5, right? Here you can see it is S5. Okay, we don't need to go back to the diagram again because we are having everything here in our hand. Okay, so our stack will become 0 and we have shifted to 5. Okay, so we have right here we had a shift operation. Okay, so for whose symbol it is happened for ID. Okay, what left in the input is multiplication, then ID, then plus ID and dollar. Okay, now at this step, if you see top of the stack, we have 5. Okay, so here we have 5, and in the symbol, we got ID. Right, so what happens if you go to state 5? This is the state 5 here. Okay, and if you see for ID, it is blank. Sorry, no, no it, sorry, it is not decided by ID, it is decided by the multiplication time symbol. Okay, current input symbol here is this multiplication. So look at the match at fifth state for multiplication, we have R6. Okay, so we have R6 here. R6 means reduction of rule number 6. So what was the rule number 6? Rule number 6 was F to ID. I think you remember. Okay, so F to ID, if reduced, then what will happen? This ID will be replaced by, so reduction happens basically, you know, it is reduction is decided by top of the stack and current input symbol, and it happens in the symbols. Okay, so this ID will be replaced by reduced to F. Okay, what then, what are the things we will have in the input is star ID plus ID and dollar. But when reduction happens, what we have to do, we need to understand. This 5 will be out of the stack, it will be popped out. Top of the stack will become 0, and that means the 0th state. Okay, and in the symbol we have if. So 0 and if, this combination we have to check. You can see if whenever you will have a reduction is always followed by go to. Okay, so you will get a go to here. Okay, so top of the stack is 0, f, go f, and f here, so it is 3. So 3 will be inserted onto the stack. I think it is clear to you. Okay, so now this is our current situation. Top of the stack is 3. Current input symbol is asterisk. Okay, now check what is the entry is there at 3 and asterisk. This is 3. At asterisk, there is a reduction 4. What was the fourth rule? I think you remembered. That was T2F. Okay, so R4, which is basically T2F. Okay, that means this F will be reduced to T. Okay, top of the stack will be removed and 0 will be inserted. So we have top of the stack 0, and here in the symbol T, we have to see what is the destination 0 and T. It is 2. So 2 will be put on the top of the stack. Okay, and input still remains the same. Okay, now top of the stack is 2, and our current input symbol is asterisk. So look at this. 2 and asterisk, we have S7. So it is saying that you shift to 7. When we have a shift, we don't do anything. We just do this. We put the new state on the top of the stack. So 0, 2, and 7 will be the stack content. And the current input symbol for which the shift happened, we'll shift that symbol to the symbol part. So asterisk will come here. Okay, what remains in the input is ID plus ID and dollar. Okay, now top of the stack is 7, and current input symbol is ID. Go to the 7th state in the table, and for ID there is a shift to S, you know, 5th state, the S5. Okay, so again we have a shift. So if there is a shift, then we don't do anything. We just insert the new state on the top of the stack. That is, sorry, I on the top of the stack, that is 5 here. We have inserted, and we do the no, move this symbol for which the shift happened in the symbol part. So T multiplication ID will be here. Okay, and what will remain here, plus ID and dollar. Understand? Now top of the stack is 5, and current input symbol is plus sign. So go to 5 plus, you have reduction of 6. So what was the sixth rule? I think you remember. That is, R6 is basically F 2 ID. Yes. So I have noted here so that in future we should not forget. So we do this reduction here. So ID will be reduced to F. Okay, top of the stack will be removed, and what you have to see, top of the stack, and after removing the top of the stack, what is the new top of the stack? That is 7. And this F, what is the combination entry is there in the table? So 7 and F, you can see it is 10. Okay, so here we will have 0, 2, 7, and 10. Okay, and input will remain like this. Okay, so again, top of the stack is 10 and current input is plus. Look at this. Yep, this is the stand state. 10 and plus, it is R3. Okay, R3. So R3 was basically T2F multiplication F. Okay, T2T multiplication F. Okay, so this whole thing we have available here, right? So we will just do this reduction, and this three symbols are replaced by T. Okay, so when this happens, we have to understand that how many symbols we have popped out from the stack, sorry, from the symbols. Okay, how many symbols we have popped out from the symbols part? Three. So what we will do? Three state will pop out from the stack also. Okay, so what we have after popping out three state, we have zero on the top of the stack. So zero and T, what is the combination? We have to find out. See, zero state, if you see T, we have two. So it will be zero and two in the stack. The input will remain same. Understand? Now, top of the stack and current input is plus. Top of the stack is 2. So 2 and plus, what is the combination? Again, it is saying the reduction of R2. I think you remember R2 is the rule number 2, which was E2T. Okay? That means this T is going to be reduced to E. How many symbols is reduced? One symbol. So one symbol from the stack will pop out. Okay, now top of the stack is zero and we have E here. So zero state E go to function giving you one. Okay, so the stack will become zero and one. Okay, input remains same. Now again, top of the stack is 1 and current input symbol is plus. So 1 and plus, it gives shift 6. So what we do in case of 6, we just put the new state on the top of the stack and we move this current symbol to the symbol part. Okay, so what symbols will remain here is ID and dollar. So top of the stack right now is 6 and current input is IDs. So go to 6th state ID, it gives us S5. Okay, so we will just push this 5 on the top of the stack. E plus, this ID will be moved to symbols, and in the input only dollar will remain. Now look at this, 5 and dollar. What is the decision here? You can see here it is R6 in the table. So it is saying R6, we already know what is R6, that is F2 ID. okay, so this ID will be popped out, sorry, this ID will be replaced by reduced to F. So it will become E plus F. How many symbol is reduced? One symbol. So one state will be popped out from the stack. So top of the stack becomes 6, and this big, you know, here we get F. Okay, we reduced to F. Okay, so go to 6 and look at F. It gives us 3. So it will be, the stack will be 0, 1, 6, and 12. Okay, dollar in the input. Now decide. Sorry, 6. I have written 12. That will be 3, right? Sorry, it is 3. See, 6 and F, we have 3. So it will be 3. Okay, so top of the stack is 3 and current input is dollar. Okay, so 6 and top of the stack is 3 and dollar giving us R4. Okay, so R4 was basically T2F, right? T2F was the fourth row. Okay, so basically this F will be reduced by T, and these things will remain like this. How many symbols we have reduced? One symbol. So one state will be popped out from the stack. So top of the stack becomes 6, and we have T here. So 6 and T, if you see the combination, it is 9. So 0, 1, 6, and 9 will be in the stack. Okay. And input is only dollar. Okay. Now look at the combination of 9 and dollar. 9 and dollar gives us R1. Okay. R1 means what? E2E plus T. These three symbols are going to be reduced by E. So three symbols from the stack I popped out. I got 0 remains there. The 0 to E gives us the combination to 1. Okay. And in the input only dollar remains. Now 1 at the top of the stack, and in input, current input is epsilon. If you see this combination, it is accept. So our parsing is successful because we got accepted here. In the input, no input symbol is remaining, only dollar is there. Okay, in the symbol you can see we have reduced to the start symbol of the grammar E. So we can say it is a successful successful parsing.